Change of speech. Our next chapter for verbal ability. There are two types of speech, direct and indirect speech. Let's first understand what is direct speech. In direct speech, we convey the message of the speaker in his own actual words without any change to another person. Then we'll understand indirect speech. In indirect speech, we convey the message of the speaker in our own words to another person. Now, to convert direct speech into indirect speech, we have to follow a procedure. So now, let's understand the procedure of changing direct speech into indirect speech. First, remove comma and inverted commas. Second step, put that between the reporting and reported speeches. Now, you can also see sentences in indirect sentence without use of that, because putting that is totally optional. Then the next step is to change the pronoun of direct speech. And then the next step is to change the tense of the direct speech appropriately. Then the last step is to change the words expressing nearness in time or places of direct speech into its appropriate words. Now, if we try to understand this procedure step by step, then removing comma and inverted commas is not a rocket science or not a big thing. And then the second step, putting that between the reporting and the reported speech, is again well understood. But understanding the third, fourth, and fifth step is really very important. So let's understand the third step, that is change in pronouns. The pronouns of the direct speech are changed wherever necessary, according to the relations with the reporter and his hearer. And to get through this more clearly, we have to also understand the first person, second person, and third person pronouns. Now, first person is the I or we perspective. Second person is the you perspective. And third person is the he, she, it, or they perspective. Now, if we change the direct speech into indirect speech, the pronouns will change in the following way. Let's see this table. If the reporting verb refers to third person pronouns, then first person pronouns I, me, us, we, mine, our in reporting speech change into third person pronouns he, she, it, they, him, his, her, hers, them, their, and theirs. For example, I will go for a walk, she told me. In indirect speech, it will be she told me that she would go for a walk. Here, I is changed to she. Then the second rule, the second person of the reported speech, you, changes according to the object of reporting speech. For example, he says to them, you have completed your job. And in indirect speech, it will be he tells them that they have completed their job. Now here, you is changed to they. Next rule, the third person pronouns he, she, it, they, him, his, her, them, their, theirs do not change at all in reported speech. For example, she says she is in 10th class. In indirect speech, it will be she says that she is in 10th class. Now here, she remains same. Then we'll understand the next step of the procedure, that is change in tense. First rule, simple present changes to simple past. Direct speech is, I always drink coffee, she said. In indirect speech, it will be, she said that she always drank coffee. Next rule is, present continuous changes to past continuous. The direct speech is, I am reading a book, he explained. And in indirect speech, it will be, he explained that he was reading a book. Next rule, present perfect changes to past perfect. For example, she said he has finished his work. In indirect speech, it will be, she said that he had finished his work. Next rule, present perfect continuous changes to past perfect continuous. For example, I have been to Spain, he told me. Indirect speech will be, he told me that he had been to Spain. Next rule is, simple past changes to past perfect. For example, bill arrived on Saturday, he said. The indirect speech will be, he said that bill had arrived on Saturday. Next rule is, past perfect stays as past perfect. We see no change in tense here. For example, I had just turned out the light, he explained. And the indirect speech will be, he explained that he had just turned out the light. Next rule, past continuous changes to past perfect continuous. Example, we were living in Paris, they told me. In indirect speech it will be, they told me that they had been living in Paris. Next rule, future changes to present conditional. For example, I will be in Geneva on Monday, he said. In indirect speech it will be, he said that he would be in Geneva on Monday. Next rule, future continuous changes to conditional continuous. For example, she said, I will be using the car next Friday. In indirect speech it will be, she said that she would be using the car next Friday. Then one more important aspect is change in modals. Let's have a look at this table. Here the first rule is, can changes to could. For example, he said, I can drive a car. In indirect speech it will be, he said that he could drive a car. Next is, may changes into might. He said, I may buy a computer. In indirect speech it will be, he said that he might buy a computer. Then the next rule is, must changes into had to. He said, I must work hard. And in indirect speech it will be, he said that he had to work hard. Then let's look at those modals which do not change, like would, could, might, should or ought to. For example, if we see would, then he said he would apply for a visa. Then in indirect speech it will be, they said that they would apply for visa. Then we'll see for could, he said, I could run faster. In indirect speech it will be, he said that he could run faster. Then comes might. Example, John said, I might meet him. In indirect speech it will be, John said that he might meet him. Next is should. He said, I should avail the opportunity. And in indirect speech it will be, he said that he should avail the opportunity. Then comes ought to. Example, he said to me, you ought to wait for him. The indirect speech will be, he said to me that I ought to wait for him. Then we'll see the change of the words which are expressing nearness in time or places. Like here becomes there, today becomes that day, this morning becomes that morning, yesterday becomes the day before, tomorrow becomes the next day, next week becomes the following week, next month becomes the following month, now becomes then, ago becomes before, thus becomes so, last night becomes the night before, this becomes that, this becomes those, hither becomes thither, hence becomes thence, come becomes go. So these are the rules for direct and indirect speech. You will understand it better once you go through the practice papers.